Hello friends, today we are going to discuss a new topic, that is your decimals. Before this video, you must observe the other videos of fractions. If you are able to understand the concept fraction, then you can easily clear your concept about your decimals. Before decimals, I am going to explain, give a brief introduction about number system or expansion of number. If I use the word 2, 3, 4, 5, this is a number 2345, and I say write it expanded form. How you write? You must start to count from left, from your right hand side. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. That we know that these are ones, tens, hundreds, and thousands. Ones, tens, hundreds, and thousands. Clear? This is for your understanding. Now, when we are going to expand this one, what is this word? This is your 2000. Means what? 2 multiplied by 1000. Clear? This is 2300. So this must be bracket plus. It's a 300 new position. 100th position. 100th position. So again in bracket 3 into 100. 2340. 40. Then 5. Now, what you are observing, that in this case it's a 2000, so we write 2 into 1300, so 3 into 100, 44 into 10, 5, then 5 into 1. Means what? Each multiplicator represent the place of the particular digit. For this, it's a 1's place, so it's multiplied by 1. It's at 10's place, so multiplied by 10. It is a 100's place, so it's a 100's place, so it is 3 into 100. It is a 1000 place, so 2 into 1000. So this is the concept of simple number. But if your number look like 2345.13, then how you represent this one? This is a critical condition. So for this, we again write 2 into 1000 plus 3 into 100 plus 4 into 10 plus 5 into 1. That is your common one. But what about after decimal 1, 3? Decimal means the number, counting of the number start from, previously we start from right to left. In this case we start from left to right. Here, before decimal, we start to count the place from this direction, and after decimal, we start to count the place from this direction. Clear? So, in this case, we have 1, or decimal 1. Decimal 1 means what? It's a 1 upon 10. So, you must write down over here, plus 1 into 1 upon 10. And what does it mean? 3. Decimal 1, 3. While writing the expanded form, we consider it's a decimal 0, 3. Means what? Plus 3 into 1 upon 100. So we can expand it likewise. Now, what is the main motive to explain you these two terms in expanded form, these two numbers in expanded form, because to discuss about the place value, you all of you know about the phase value, that the number itself is a phase value. What I discuss, I'm going to discuss about the place value of these two numbers. So I'm going to rub this one. As you know that we have written two numbers, this and this number. There are two numbers we discussed. Now, if I said that place value, so it's a place, and then if we consider the value, we must write down value, then we have number. What number we have? Always remember, while drawing the place value table, we first check that largest place value. In this case, we have largest place value is 1000, so we move up to one more, 10,000. So, what we write? This place value having 10,000. It's a 10,000, then we have 1000, hundreds, then tens, ones, after that we have some decimal also. So in decimal, we after ones, what is one? Here, tens. So after, just after one, what we have? Right, it's a tenth. TH, tenth. And then S, tens, hundreds. So while placing these two numbers into a place value table, we must write down these things. First, place, values and number, these three rows are defined. Then in place, we must write down the name of the places. So here, what we are observing, there are four places. Before decimal, we have four places. Means what? Ones, tens, hundred and thousands. So in this case, we move likewise. I have extended one only. So 10,000, there is no one. We always remember that after decimal, it plays a place of tenth, th. So we have written one after ones. I will not make a column for decimal, but just after tenth, ones, I write over the tenth, th. We add th as a suffix, tenths and hundreds and thousands, th. We must add th. So what are the value of this? Value of this one is 10,000. It's a 1000, 100, 10 and 1. Value of these are this one. Then I am going to plot this one. It's a 2, 3, 4, 5. Here I have written some big numbers so that you can easily understand. This is for the number 2, 3, 4, 5. But what about this number? For second number, again we can write 2, 3, 4, 5. Clear? But still, in this case, we have two decimal number also. So for that decimal number, we must come. What is the value of this 10? This 10's value is 1 upon 10. And this 100's value is 1 upon 100. Clear? So, in this case, what we can write? For 1 upon 10, we can easily write itself 1. We can easily write the number itself. It's a 1. It's a 3. So this is about place value table for whole number and decimal numbers. Clear? If only decimal numbers are given, then need not to draw this up to this one from here and here. Only start from this place to this place and that column. This is about place value table. Yes, students, what you are observing in this figure, this is a number line and there are some numbers in decimal form. Question is, how we represent a decimal number on a number line? So as we know that for every decimal number, here I am discussing only the decimal number up to one digit. If you know the concept of one digit, then you are able to draw the number line of two digit, but that is of higher classes. So in this case, what we are observing that there are some mark 0, 1, 2, 3, and in between 0 and 1 there are some divisors which divide the place of 0 to 1 into 10 equal parts. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again, 1 to 10, there is some 10 equal division, 1 to 2, sorry. Then 2 to 3, again some 10 equal divisions. And here, we have some numbers. As we know that 0.7, if we discuss about 0.7, and I said to you that convert into fraction, then you can easily convert this into 7 upon 10. Clear? Why 7 upon 10? Then this is upload of how we convert this decimal into fraction. But we always remember that this is law. This is the expanded form of the 0.71. Because this comes at after one digit of decimal, so it's a 1/10 and 7. So what we discussed that this 7 represents 7 times 1/10 number. Means what? Out of 10 we need 1. So out of 10 we need 1. This is for 1, this part. But 7 such parts we needed. So we move 1, 2, 3, not count 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the place where the digit 0.7 come on number line. If you are unable to understand this way, so clear the concept. After decimal, we know that we have 10th divisions. 10th are there. So 10th is there. 7 itself, 0.7 means 7, th. Means what? After decimal, we have one digit. So 1.5th, 2.9th. So after means what? 0 means what? In between this number lies between 0 and 1. This one is clear. And then there are 7. Out in between 0 and 1, that seventh number position. Seventh number position. So it's a 1, 2, 3 and there's the seventh. Then what about 1.5? 1 is the whole number. So if we expand this one, what we know? We know that 1 into 1 plus 5 into 1 upon 10. That is, you know. So that fifth part after the basic, after one, fifth part we need. And from here also, this is your whole number part. So after one, we need how much more? We need five places. So after one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This one is a place for 1.5. So similarly, 2.9. For 2.9, after 2, we count 9 equal division. So it's easier for you that this one is place for 2.9. So likewise, you must draw the number lines for decimal numbers. So the question arises, write decimal numbers into words. How we write decimal numbers into word, or how we pronounce that number into word in our language? Generally, we are not going into so much typical mathematical language. We use some easiest part so that you can write properly or you can understand properly, and other also can understand what you want to discuss or what you want to tell. For example, I am choosing one number from a book. It's a 47.20. I think all of you must hear my voice, what I pronounce it while writing this one. Make this in your practice, that after decimal, we never count this number as 20. We after decimal, we count the digit only. Means here we are 47.20, no, it's wrong. If we write 47.20, then it is right. So this is the your word conversion. You must write 47.20 or 20. 20 means what? 00. So you must write down 2 and 0. But actually 47.20 means 47.2 then 0. But for clear explanation, you can write down 47.2 and 0. If I see your book, one more exam question came into my mind, that is your how to write down this number 26.039. This one better explains you. So what do we write? 26.039. Then each digit 039. Or 03 and 9, whatever you want. 26.039 is a proper way. So here you may write, may not write 2, but okay, may for the sake of uniformity, write, need not write and. Clear? So likewise, you can solve such type of questions. Then there is a question that we have to place the given decimal numbers into place value table. That place value table format I given just a few minutes before in this video. So all of you, and also expanded form. So your work is you have to complete 7.1 exercise 1, 2, 3 for today. And yes, if you people are observing this video till this part, I want to know that how much of you reach up to this part. So all of you, if you are observing this part, then you must write your name in a comment part of this video. As soon as you complete the video, go to the comment part and write down your name. I want to see that how many of you are observing, who is observing my video completely. That's all for today. Thank you.